Okay, so the next thing is blockage boundary. And for this, there is a model which you can directly use in your system. Okay. So you know too low airflow is also a problem because you can block the line. All right? Let's carry on. Yeah. So you need to know the blockage limit. So earlier, just carry on. So next one. Yeah. So earlier people, what they used to, they were under the belief that that for dense space you require certain velocity, and for a particular product that velocity is good enough. So if it is 3 meters per second, 5 meters per second, it's only velocity. You just get that, give that velocity, and you would get the product to flow.
Yeah.
So we convert one powder through a test rig, 2.5 inch diameter and 168 meter long, and you know by now that this is the minimum, this is the blockage boundary. So we just drew a line, and the corresponding velocity was coming 3 meters per second.
Okay. Then what we did, we replaced that line. We went for a larger pipeline.
And what is the velocity we are getting now? 3.7 meters per second, okay? And we tested this approach for other products also.
And
what we found that when you scale up your pipe diameter, you require more air velocity. When you scale up the pipe diameter, you require more velocity. Whereas the earlier school of thought was, for one product, you need one velocity irrespective of the pipe diameter, right? So we thought, is there any number which tackles that diameter approach, diameter into consideration? So we have, what we do instead of velocity, we do it by Fraud number, okay? So the advantage you get is, if your diameter goes up, it tells you require higher velocity, okay? But overall, your Fraud number value still remains the same. See, we want to give a formula which will be applicable for a range of bulk solids. So can we have that, okay? So we found that for that particular product, both the
blockage boundaries,
3 meters per second, Fraud number is 3.6. 3.7 meters per second, it's again 3.6, right? So we thought, there might be something important here. Instead of velocity, let's try to model the blockage boundary using Fraud number criteria. So we did that for various products. So these are all different fly ash samples. And we found that if you deal with Fraud number instead of velocity, you get a lesser amount of range, okay? So next one. So these are all different fly ash, right? Convert through various pipelines. So 1, 2, 3, 4, I think about 12, 10 fly ash samples, convert through different pipelines. And we found that the Fraud number range is something between 3.6 to 5. But if you just calculate the corresponding velocities, you get a larger range in velocity. So then what we recommend, that for fine powders, which are aerated, fly ash and cement, with some 20% margin, we design our system corresponding to Fraud number equal to 6, right? So if you see somewhere a pressure conveying, by the way, this is for pressure. If you see somewhere a pressure conveying system having, say, 6-inch pipe diameter, having, say, 6-inch pipe diameter, and it is having, say, roughly some inlet velocity, say 8 meters per second. Now, if you have an 8-inch pipe, so will you use 8 meters per second? No, you're not going to use 8 meters per second. So you have to make sure that you give something which is greater than 8 meters per second. How much that is? So you just calculate Fraud number at the blow tank. So this is at the blow tank, is the velocity. I need to calculate that velocity divided by root G into 8 inch, right? So this is equal to how much? This is equal to 6. So from here you can calculate that what is the minimum velocity you require to convey the product. So we have tested that one of my latest PhD students, he had validated this for 22 fine powders. So that information, it must be in that course note, I can send you. So 22 products convert through 38 pipelines, right? And it comes within frog number 6. So if you go with frog number 6, maybe just for safety, you can add frog number 7. So you should be able to convey fine powders, which are capable to go into fluidized space, right? But if it is vacuum, in the vacuum, your pressure is less, right? So ultimately, it's a game of momentum, right? So in the vacuum, the air is thinner. So do you require less velocity or high velocity?
High velocity.
Because in the dense, in the positive pressure system, your pressure is more. Your density, correspondingly, air density is also more. So when you have the air having high density, so you can move the product at a lower velocity. Okay? So for vacuum conveying system, we would go for, I would go for at least Prandtl number equal to 12 for fine powders. Is it correct for Mahesh or a little bit more?
It's a good starting point.
Yeah. So for dense phase, you go for Prandtl number equal to 6. For dilute phase, you go for minimum 12. If possible, you go for even higher. Because in dilute, what also happens is, your air is thinner, so you require higher velocity, right?